So, how many of you have heard of Greta Thunberg? Yes. Greta is awesome. So obviously, I'm not Greta. But I am here to make sure that you all know that Greta is right. Climate change is real. Yep. It's real. It's happening now, and we have to do something about it right away. So in my work, I focus on solutions. So I'm here to help motivate you all to take immediate, collective, specific action to address the climate crisis. So far, there has been a rather dangerous lack of action. This is for many reasons, but mostly it's about a rather small number of companies making a rather large amount of money and using their money and power to lobby against climate action and question climate science. If we had started taking action a few decades ago, we would have only needed to reduce our emissions by a small amount per year, making for a nice, gentle slope, kind of like skiing down the bunny hill. But we waited at the top of the hill for a really long time, and now we're staring down at the double black diamond. We can still reduce our emissions in time to avoid catastrophic climate change, but we have to do it really, really fast. So point your ski tips down the hill, everyone. It's time to go. Along with graphs, scientists have tried to convey the urgency of the situation with strongly worded statements. It sounds incredible, but it's true that the actions that we take in the next decade will impact all life on Earth for the next century and beyond. If we don't start reducing emissions immediately, we will start hitting dangerous tipping points, like all the ice and permafrost melting, or forests drying out and burning down. This will cause rapidly increased heating, along with sea level rise, and extreme events like storms, fires, floods, and droughts. We can see that these things are already starting to happen, many faster than predicted. Nobody knows exactly what will happen next, because the global climate is a complicated system, and we've never run this exact experiment of cooking our planet before. But we do know that every reduction in emissions matters, and the faster the better. 2 degrees is better than 3, which is better than 4. I would like us all to move quickly together through the stages of climate grief. Certainly right past denial, and then through anger, bargaining, and depression to acceptance and action. It's okay if you need to spend a little extra time feeling angry, because what is happening is absolutely infuriating. And it is okay if you need to spend a little extra time feeling sad, because what is happening is tragic. But after you spend some time lying on the couch with a cheesecake or whatever you need to do, I need you to put the cheesecake down and get up and join us all in taking action. We need courage to take action, and the more action we take together, the more courage we will have. And there are actually reasons to have courage. Yes, climate change is real, and it is happening very quickly. But the other thing that is happening very quickly is that solutions to climate change are getting very cheap. This is a fun graph. In the orange part, you can see how the costs for manufacturing solar panels have come down dramatically over time, from over $100 a watt in the 1970s to now just about 30 cents. And in the blue part, you can see how, as costs have come down, installations have spiked. Solar is now the cheapest form of energy on Earth. It's not the 1970s anymore. People are putting solar panels everywhere. In China, they're even building giant panda-shaped solar farms. It's very cute. In many countries around the world, they're building solar at massive scale and at smaller scale, building microgrids with solar and batteries to bring energy to people who are not connected to the grid. In much the same way that many people skipped landline telephones and went straight to cell phones, many people are skipping the fossil fuel grid and going straight to clean, renewable, distributed energy resources. It's also not just the costs of solar that are coming down. Costs for wind and batteries are falling very quickly. Just last month, Rocky Mountain Institute published a report showing that combinations of wind, solar, batteries, and efficiency can actually be almost always cheaper than building a new gas-fired power plant. The old story was that gas is the bridge to our renewable energy future. The new story is the bridge was shorter than we thought. We've already crossed it. We are in the renewable energy future. It's another tipping point, the good kind of tipping point. If we can make all electricity clean and many things electric, this will go a long way to reducing our emissions. Even in industries that are harder to clean up, like shipping and aviation, we do have solutions that can bring their emissions down. A lot of this involves efficiency, the circular economy, and using cheap renewable electricity to make ammonia and hydrogen. And if you'd like to read more about those technical details, you can check out the Mission Possible report. Overall, we believe there are many signs that the transition to a clean energy future is accelerating. Just like many people didn't expect the transition from landline phones to cell phones to go so quickly, or even the transition from horse-drawn carriages to cars taking over Fifth Avenue in Manhattan in just over a decade, people aren't really good at evaluating exponential curves. So we believe that the transition to clean energy will happen faster than many people expect. And there are things that we can all do to push it to go even faster. The great thing about doing these things is that we aren't just fighting for survival, although I hope that's important to you. We're fighting for a better future. We'll have cleaner air and water and great jobs for everyone, bikes, parks, walkable neighborhoods. It will be glorious. They're already starting to do this in many places around the world, and we can do it here too. Still, I know that people are busy, and so even if the cause is a habitable planet, you can probably only take a few actions. So I'd like to recommend a few actions with the highest impact on reducing your emissions. These actions aren't just good for reducing emissions, they are also fun and cheaper and better in many ways. So first, you could install solar. As we already know, solar is now one of the cheapest forms of energy on Earth. You could buy it right up front and never pay for electricity again, or you could lease it, pay nothing up front, and pay less per month than you are now. We've had solar in our house for about 10 years, and a lot of our neighbors have it now. Ask your neighbors who installed their solar, or if you live somewhere where solar doesn't work well for you, you can switch your electric bill to a renewable energy rate offered by most utilities. Next, you could get an electric car. Teslas are great, but so are Nissan Leafs and Chevy Bolts and all of the other ones that are now available. Many of them are cheaper right up front than gas cars, and there are tax credits, and they are much cheaper to operate and maintain. They are also way more fun to drive. They are faster and smoother and quieter, and I promise, charging is not that hard. You can do it right at home. There are many more charging stations being built every day, and you'll be so happy to never go to a gas station again. Perhaps even better than an electric car, you could get an electric bike. Our kids love our e-bikes so much that they even prefer it to the Tesla. It is so much fun for riding around town, and it can replace a car for most trips. Finally, you could consider flying less frequently. Flying isn't even that fun anymore, anyway. Become an unfrequent flyer. Then you can skip the security lines. Just tell your boss you're going to skip that next trip because of the climate crisis, and because flying isn't fun, and because you could do this meeting by video probably anyway. These are just a few ideas to get you started. Of course, if you have the energy to do more things, do more things. You could plant trees, you could eat less meat, you could check out resources like Project Drawdown for more ideas. But if you only have the energy to do one thing, this is the thing I would recommend. Become a climate activist. You don't have to strike every week with Greta. You could start with some of the easier activist activities, like talking to your friends about the climate crisis, or voting. Please definitely vote. Wow. Yes. And then you could participate in some of the more general strikes and protests, because research shows that just 3.5% of the population participating in nonviolent social protest is the most effective way to make big structural change happen. And we know that this challenge is so enormous that we will need big structural change. We went from just Greta striking a year ago to over 7 million people striking a month ago. We can do this. I know you all care about the climate crisis, and it's important to act to show how much you care. So I want you all to commit to the people sitting next to you now, to taking just one easy action tomorrow, whether it's skipping the meat, or riding your bike, or switching your electric rate to the renewable option. And then do one more thing the day after that. Put a reminder on your calendar to do something every week, or every month, or at least every year of this very important next decade of your life, and my life, and our children's lives, and all life on Earth, our home. Thank you.